In my life, it doesn't like roll off the tongue on my press release for me to talk about crying on my kitchen floor because I feel like I'm a failure. And it's not good, I'm sure, when you're trying to pitch to investors that it's August 31st and you have to make payroll September 1st and you don't actually know how you're gonna do that.
The amount of people that came up to us after that talk with tears in their eyes telling us that he has absolutely changed their lives, I can't even count on two hands. It was unbelievable.
I don't know, it's so hard to read. Are you looking out, out for me?
I'm doing this tour across Canada, and I see that I'm playing this show in a town called Fort McLeod in Alberta. Nobody goes, woo, because nobody's from there, right?
You're able to relate to him and actually see yourself reflected in the stories that he shares.
And there are 300 people there. And not only are they there, but they are like freaking out. They are screaming my name and they're requesting songs and they know all of my lyrics. And I'm just playing this show and I'm like, somebody made a lot of money off of me and I don't know how.
I felt like he understood me and I understood him. There was 400 people in the room, but I felt like we were connected.
So basically, for many years, every summer, like hundreds of kids are being forced to learn my music. This is amazing. How do we scale this up and do this everywhere, right? Trying to use your language here, right? Okay.
You know, there's a lot of performers and speakers who speak or just sing, but to combine those with a real message that hits the heart, that's what Peter Katz does.
And when your biggest fear, it ends up coming true. It's when you find out what you have inside of you.
So the number one question that I ask myself whenever I'm asked to speak to people is, how do your experiences and my experiences overlap? In your lives, you have these ideas called startups and apps, businesses, and whatever it is that you do, whatever that has brought you here. But just like in my life, that final outcome, whether that thing that you've put all this love and attention, care, and detail to, you don't actually have any guarantee that that thing is gonna work.
For me, it was very therapeutic, just being able to be vulnerable in front of like people I've never met before, like a crowd of 400 people. I'm like, I'm just gonna let it all out.
And you put your energy into it, but there is a cost. It can be isolating. It can be hard, it can feel like there's always this kind of black cloud of, is this really gonna work, over your head all the time.
He is just so raw and authentic.
He was personal, he was vulnerable.
There are many people who describe themselves as inspirational or can bring inspiring stories. There are few who can connect on an emotional level the way Peter can.
I had this new part inside of me that knew that I was strong, I was courageous, and that eventually, I was gonna be okay.
I go to a lot of conferences, as many people do. I've never seen people get as emotionally involved at a conference.
Toughing it out and staying in it and finding those little moments where that thing that you're putting out into the world is finding a way out there. You get to look in the mirror and look at yourself and say, I deserve to be proud of myself, not only for what I'm doing, but for how I'm doing it.
You know, it's, I'm kind of tired of Peter, because he went on before me and everybody loved him. And you know, when you're giving a speech, you really hope that the people before you will really suck. So I was devastated by how good he was.